So allow me to invite onto stage our three panelists and our moderator. So first of all, inviting on stage from Sadara Chemical Company, Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Ziad Al-Laban. Welcome. Please come and take a seat on the stage. We're also going to be joined by Kuwait Petroleum Corporation, Managing Director for Planning and Finance, Mrs. Wafa Al-Zayabi. Welcome, marhaba. And joining them is going to be KNPC's CEO, Mr. Mohamed Al-Materi. Welcome back. And then Equate's President and CEO, Mr. Mohamed Hussein. He's going to be moderating this panel discussion. Good morning and welcome, Mohamed. Now, Mr. Hussein has been the President and CEO of Kuwait since 2012, and with over 30 years of extensive professional service, he previously held various leading posts, administrative and technical, at Kuwait Oil Company, Petrochemical Industries Company, and Kuwait National Petroleum Company, and in 2015 spearheaded Equate's full acquisition of Me Global. So this is where I hand over to Hussein for his 45-minute discussion, and I'm going to get some mics on. Hussein, over to you. Please.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سيد نزال عساني نائب الرئيس ورئيس تنفيذي كي بي سي، الحضور الكرام، صباحكم الله بخير، السلام عليكم، حياكم الله. I think the intention of this panel is really something just to raise sometime the awareness and to engage the leadership. None of us claim to be expert in cybersecurity, except maybe Wafa. No, none of us really had that intention to be expert. However, I think we also, four of us, believe cybersecurity is not limited to just the technical. The responsibility of the leaders is really very critical. The commitment of the leaders is a milestone in making it happen. The awareness of the leaders is very critical to be aware what is happening around them and the criticality of this undertaking. The purpose today is really to dialogue from leadership point of view, dialogue from responsibility point of view, dialogue from where we're trying to take this one and how can we really prevent our company to be attacked. The number we just seen in the movies is a scary ones. In fact, yesterday there was a discussion among leaders also, and everyone was saying we have been sort of the word they've been used is phishing. Again, I mean, I use the word phishing. I came from an island, so phishing to me means something different. But phishing here is how people are trying to really attack you and try to see how there's any weak points where they can squeeze themselves to really penetrate through your system. Today, with no doubt, our system is something very critical and very important. And we live with the technology, if we like it or not. Before proceeding with the panelists, let me share with you a few things which is we think it is a critical, and I will introduce the three panelists accordingly. Our objective, actually, and I just echo what Bughazi said, to thank the organizing committee and thanks KNPC, really, to really sponsor this one very much, and all our sponsor, which has really been part of this event. So really, a big thank you very much in there. Also, I want to say it's important to understand that our objective today is really to network, to connect, to try and make our professionals also and our leaders to talk to each other, to make sure we learn from each other. Also, we're trying to really disseminate the knowledge. And I think this is very important for us. How can we disseminate the knowledge in this arena? How can we really raise the awareness, which is the third thing which is mentioned very much in there? In Equate, we have a belief to need to be build a culture, what we call it, the high reliable organization. It's all about reliabilities. Reliability of the people, reliability of the system, and the reliability of the plant. That's what we are really trying to push for, that high reliable. However, the reliability is we're trying to push it as a cultural intention. That's to be part of our culture, that we are really reliable. Very critical in this mission to be proactive, as been said in the movie also. Being proactive, trying to be ahead of the incidents is far better than just trying to just later on to fix it and make sure we contain it afterward. Having said that one, again, let me just briefly introduce the three panelists. And I will start with Mr. Ziad Al-Labban. Ziad have a long career in this industry. In fact, he started in the downstream, in the refining, and the refining. And also he was posted in Houston, Texas with Aramco. Ziad also was the CEO of Petrorabigh, which is 400,000 ton of petrochemical and Sarine refinery petrochemical integrated project, which is really one of the initial integrated plant. And today, Ziad is the CEO of Sadara, which is one of the largest integrated complex, I would say not in the region, maybe Ziad in the world in total. So he is leading that Sadara project, and we wish him all the best, really. He's a chemical engineer, and he, as I said, been in this industry for more than 30 years, and I'll stop there, Ziad. Wafa Al-Zaabi has been in KBC her career. She has deep knowledge in strategy, deep knowledge in the operation and planning, and managing the performance. Is very instrumental in a lot of deals, especially in the understanding of the gas and trying to make sure the connectivity of this region together. She is very critical in the financial and the planning area of KBC. She is was in the board members of Assur, a fuel company, and she holds a chemical engineering and master degrees in chemical engineering of Kuwait University. Mr. Mohammed Ghazi is long career in the refining side. His career been always been in KMPC, the Kuwait National Petroleum Company. He held also a chemical engineers, chemical engineering degrees. And Mohammed really started very much in the operational side. So when we talk about the operational, he been managing two big refineries in Kuwait in the past. He also was the DMD for Mina Al-Ahmadi Refinery and other refineries. And he, in 2012, and recently he's. Actually, not recently. I'm trying just to look at the date. 2013, he became the CEO of KMBC. So please welcome the panelists with me here today. Just before start dialoguing with the panelists and trying to move this one forward, let me share with you some information. And I think sometime the information give us sort of understanding of the magnitude we are dealing with. Bughazi in his introduction, Mohammed Hamtari in his introduction, he mentioned value, dollars value, which is really tremendous. In 2015, he said, we have almost, the losses contribute to almost $1 trillion. $1 trillion attributed to the cybersecurity issues. That's not simple as $1 trillion. He also mentioned that in 2016, this number could anticipated to reach $2.1 trillion. So the number is really increasing. It's not something which is stagnant and is in there. We think the best defense we can build is the knowledge sharing. That's really one of the best defenses we have is that knowledge sharing. And the most critical knowledge sharing is having our employee understand the magnitude and the availability of the information to them to understand the risk associated with the cybersecurity, especially in the operation side. And that's where the focus will be very much. We are talking, we know the IT side has been hit a lot, but the operation will really become very critical, and that could be really life risking undertaken, God forbid it does happen. However, it did happen. Let me read this to you. In 2014, a steel plant in Germany, which is a steel plant in Germany, attacked by hackers. And in reality, they were able to hit the control system. And this is the dangers. When they really reached to that control system, and they did in 2014. And actually, they've been able to stop several machines, because when you control, when you have a control over the control system, you can stop the whole manufacturing side. So they've been able to stop the machines themselves. The attack in this one here really was a tremendous in there and completely seized the whole operation in the steel plant. The other reported attack was in 2010, which is hit a nuclear plant in Iran. That's what's reported. In December 2015, a power station in Ukraine was also hit by the control system, by hackers. During that attack, 200,000 users of that power, they lost their powers. That's the magnitude of the risk of these things when it does happen. Again, Shamoun 1 or Shamoun was well known to Hoover, been hit with it, and we knew Aramco were very, really thankful, very much communicative and really clear, and when they hit with that one in 2012. And today, we have Shamoun 2, which is maybe we have a chance sometime to see if somebody will elaborate on Shamoun 2, which is, did hit our IT system. Let me move to our panelists and really start the dialogue. One of the questions which has always come to us is, how much do we consider this operation technology risk? I think nobody questioning the IT side, because we've seen it. We lived it. We have everybody seen it. I remember when we came to Y2K, too many people said this was just a big Hollywood movie. Reality, is this another big Hollywood movie? Or is this something which is you really have a concern with? Let me start with you, Ziad. Just let me take your takeaway from this one, and I will move with Wafa and then Mohammed. In this specific, the criticality of it, how much you feel this is really a real risk on us, and where do you think we need to really to deal with it? And if you have an experience, please tell us with that.
Okay. Abu Abdullah, thank you very much for the introduction. OT, or operating technology, is a major concern to a company like ourselves, like many companies that use SCADA systems, DCS systems, and they're the heart of the company. The issue becomes the driving forces for the what I'm going to call the OT, the operating technology, is different than the driving forces of IT. In IT, the driving force, basically you have three items. You have confidentiality, you have the integrity of the data, and you have the access to that data. Now, when it comes to the OT side of the business, it's the other way around. What's important is getting access to data, then integrity, then lastly, the confidentiality. You want to keep the data in the hands of people so that they can operate the system. Unfortunately, and in the past, OT systems were always standalone, so it was never a problem. Nowadays, because the interactivity between the OT world and the IT world, you're opening yourself up to hackers. And they can come in through the IT area and actually attack your facilities and control them. I can tell you in Sadara, we had on January the 23rd, 8:15 in the morning, I was in a forum in Bahrain.
That's 2017.
That's 2017,
yeah.
2 months ago. And as I was giving my panel discussion, I hope it doesn't repeat itself today.
Inshallah.
I kept on, my phone kept on buzzing, vibrating. After the panel discussion, I opened it and I spoke, and they told me we've been hacked. We got hit by Shamoun too. And it brought down our whole system. What it didn't do is affect the OT side. It brought down the IT side of the system. What we did is we had a firewall between the IT and the OT. That's how we were able to survive and we were able to protect ourselves. But that is an area we have to be very careful about because, unfortunately, the IT world in today's environment is one where you have remote access. You have access that can come from anywhere in the world. We were lucky that our people saw this high activity in the active directories, and what they did is they brought down all the servers. That's what saved us. Had they not done that, we would have been for several weeks out of commission. We were able, just by bringing down the servers, we controlled it so it only affected 1,000 computers. But still, that's still a lot of disruption. The world today, when you try to get information, what you're doing by having interactions with the outside world, what you're doing is you're opening up the avenues for people to get into your systems and hack and destroy. And that's exactly what we've learned. You have to start learning and finding means to put in the firewalls, to put in the layering within your systems to try to protect it. And most importantly, and
Ziad, I want to come back later on to this area, and I want you to keep it in mind. That's the firewalls and the impact of communication later on. Allow me to move on to Wafa, and I will come back to you because we need to really sort of dialogue from responsibility from the leaders, how they're going to make the communication open and the firewalls. That's something which is, I think, will be very general. Wafa, can you just give us your views in this one?
Let me start. Thank you, Abdullah, for the introduction. It seems let me start first saying that cybersecurity is a real threat for any organization. And addressing this should be on the top of the agenda of any management and board of any organization. Because cybersecurity and the impact that has in any organization, it's not only on the organization, it's on the national security of any country. For us, if I talk about KPC, for example, KPC, any incident could happen in OT, as Mr. Ziad said, it's the heart of the operation. Any incident will happen, will impact not only the facility, it will have an impact on the economic loss of the organization. And KPC is the heart of the country. It's 90% of the revenue of Kuwait, it depends on the oil sector. So taking measures, addressing this challenge, be proactive in addressing the cybersecurity issue should be part of our agenda as a top management. It's not only even the economical loss, it's not only the facility loss, it's even our employee, the security of our employee, our reputation as an organization. So it has an impact which should be a serious threat for us that we should take care of, we should put it in our agenda as a top management, so we should aware our employees, build their capability on that.
Interestingly, and I will move you with Ghazi, Wafa is saying now about the national interest, and I think we all serve our government and our people in that sense. And also she is raising the questions around how much can we protect this one? And maybe, as I said, you feel maybe the heat, but again, how much is that heat is real?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. طبعاً, the heat is real because while coming to this conference this morning, I was going through the app of the Kiox 2017 in the Apple Store, which I downloaded 2 days ago. I want to see the program, the speaker, and at the first minute, I got error. So it was a surprise to me. Uh-oh. I said their Apple is already hacked. But anyway, I called them, and they mentioned it's an error, it's not an attack, and everything was rectified immediately. This really give you the sense that we are in a very risky environment. Absolutely. You mentioned in the question that is it serious? Yeah, definitely serious. Everybody in November, and you mentioned two examples: the manufacturer in Germany, the Iranian also nuclear plant, which has been hit by Stuxnet virus. In summer 2015, we experienced a serious attack in our IT. And it was mainly on some of the shared file and some of the user data. It's nothing serious, but thank God our IT team did take an early action at the early stage and they abort this attack. And this brings the subject of security, as mentioned by Ziad and Wafa, that OT is really vulnerable because it's not a standalone anymore. When we start, you know, manufacturing, everybody knows that OT was a standalone. But now, with time, with the, there is a link between IT and OT, and our team always do a survey for vulnerability. They have a lot of exercise. It is ongoing. They put a lot of firewalls between the two systems, but definitely this brings the subject of security. This is a critical issue. It could happen any time, any minute. And that's why the IT, I mentioned in the beginning, we are not an expert here, but thank God we have our, in this conference, a lot of expertise. We have a lot of IT specialists here that really they're working on this issue. And as I mentioned in my speech, we are giving priority and we're giving resources. And this is, as a leadership, this is our role. We give them support, we give them resources, and they will do the rest. But definitely there is a lot of surveys going on. The IT is really focusing on the, and it's a serious issue, and we have to continue in progress. It's not, we cannot relax. So definitely from the many examples, it's an threat, real threat that can cause damage to economy.
Again, I think the message from the three leaders is very simple. This is a real thing. And I think we do believe in that real thing, is how much commitment we are given. And I think Bughazi closed it, Mr. Mohammed Lomteri, nicely. He said, our role to support, to make the resources available to our people to prevent this one from happening. And I think this is something which is very critical. And I think this is the message to the all leaders. You need to pay attention to it. You make sure that's the resource available. Let me share with you two quick stories in the OT systems, which is it did happen, actually. The first one in Australia, and that was a sewage system, which has been hacked. And the result of that one was 1 million liters of the sewage was completely out of control. It hit the following: local park, a river, and a five-star hotel. So all been impacted by this hack when they really had the ability to attack the system itself. The other one is a pipeline, which is, we do have a lot of these pipelines. Today, our gas, oil, liquids, everything is control system, which is really control the flow in these ones. We measure it, we look at it, and everything. This is in Turkey, and actually in 2008, this, and this is an, really not a new 2008, and this line by hacked, the spill was 30,000 barrels of oil from that pipelines was really out of the system, and they have to clean it after. So this is the magnitude we are talking about in this side of it. Let me move on with our panelist. And Ziad, let me go back to your question. And thank you for both of you and Bughazi sharing with you your experience in the IT side. And Shimon too, which is recently, and I think Shimon also hit KMPC, and others, by the way. All of us, sometimes we don't see it, but we've been fished every second, maybe, to find a way to really penetrate our system. Having IT and OT outside or away from each other is becoming very difficult. It's not really easy to separate them. In fact, we are more in this integration. We are more in the efficiency and the effectiveness of making the decision-making process. Today, in our gadget, we see our flow, we see our how much we really receiving, what's our feed, everything. So separate them, it's becoming very difficult. How can we really manage this one? Or ultimately, we have to converge the IT and the OT together. Again, I mean, let me go back to you, as I mentioned, Ziad, if you want to take this one here.
Yeah, I can tell you that experience in Sabara. Yeah. Basically, what we've done is we've realized that it's the operations that handles the OT side of the business, and the IT is in the realm of IT, the system analyst. And that is actually a mistake. What we've learned as a result of the hacking, the recent hacking, is we actually need to get them together in a working group and have common the objective to be common, and we need to have them working together in securing the system. You cannot continue in today's environment having them separate. Everybody says, well, in the old days. Yeah, in the old days, you used to have a completely separate server, a completely separate DCS. Today, you have, you know, with your cell phone, you have full access to your operations, and you don't even get it by going into your operations. You get it from the cloud. So it's even getting more into this IT space. The only way you will ever be able to resolve that is to bring OT and IT together and start working on security.
And in your thought, I mean, Bouazi and Wafa, I mean, where do you see that separation should be? How the extent of that separation need to be done between the IT and the OT? Yeah.
It shouldn't. There should be no separation, Bouazdallah.
If you can just put the mic closer, yeah.
Yeah. Now, as you said, the world is integrated and fully integrated. So the need for that to integrate OT with IT, it's a must. Both of them, they complement each other. OT, they have the experience and the know-how about the process. The IT, they have the know-how about the systems and the processes, and we need to bridge the gap between, but they don't know the process exactly in as such. So we need to have a forum between each, both of them, to bridge the gap, to integrate each other, to align each other, and to have, I agree with Mr. Ziad, they should have a common objective. Both of them, they have to protect the processes and the organization. So they have to work together by complementing each other with the experience both of them they have.
Bouazi, let me push harder on this one. If you talk to the OT guys, they are very protective. And with no doubt, that's their system. They know this is when, God forbid, something has a disaster. The IT would like to provide you with a lot of system, a lot of maneuverabilities, a lot of communication tools, make life easier, more fun. So where do you see we can really put any barriers, or really we have just to converge at the end of the day?
Well, let me start with saying that the IT and OT, we look at KMBC as two sides of the same coin. So they complement each other. I think the maturity of the industry, as mentioned by Ziad, now we are getting a mature industry. We are moving forward in the industry of refining downstream. So at the beginning, there was a need to separate. Now, definitely, they have to converge. The OT, which was handled at the beginning by the instrument division, operation department, and also we had a group called process control. It was with the refinery, now with the different MOG department, like in sort of planning. The IT definitely from beginning was with the IT group, and we noticed the need to link. Now, there is now too many links between each other. So this is setting the base to converge in the future. We have our people here, the operation, the instrument, the process control, and the IT. They have a good chance 2 days event. So I urge them to discuss further, to evaluate the risk of converging both systems together. You mentioned the beginning, definitely now we are looking at our refinery highlight from our mobile, from our PC. We had a lot of planning engineers, they are outside of the refinery, is doing a lot of analysis, 24 hours. They need access from home. We had a lot of people even going abroad in business trip, they have access to the system. So I think the link is more. So
again,
the future is
the future. We know, Ziad already mentioned, everything's going to be in the cloud anyway. I mean, the cloud, you almost lose control over this one here. So how are you going to do it? I mean, as a leaders, I'm talking about not as a leaders, where is your concern? How are you really going to manage this one? Because the data will be in the tub there sometime.
Yeah, if I can make a comment on that, we do have to converge because of the sharing of information and technology. But I think one thing that we've also learned is there needs to be a separation when it comes to the hardware. You need to be able to have dedicated servers for the OT system and dedicated servers on the IT.
Let me push back to you. The world is going to no servers anyway, because that's cost on us. And to be more efficient, we're trying to really get this hardware away from the way and save the money for something else. So if this server's concept gone, where your concern will be?
Then security and confidentiality becomes another issue. But I'll tell you, you need servers on the OT side. Mm. And they need to be in your control and in your domain. Now, when it comes on the IT side, I agree. Then you can go to the cloud structure, whether it be on the recovery of data and things of that nature. But on the OT side, you cannot. Today, I don't believe it's wise to be going out of your...
Again, back to you, Wafaa, to the mobilities. I mean, mobility is... Bughazi said it very much clearly. He said when they travel, they want to look at this one. Mobility, control... Where do you think this will stop? Ziad beautifully said, today we should separate and make sure we have something under control. Do you think that's the way to do it at this stage and how we look at the future?
I think that we have to integrate and link them to each other strongly. And you mentioned, Abu Abdullah, at the beginning that maybe as an organization you see that sometimes you need to reduce the cost of the spending that you have spent on the OT and IT because of you want to take this money to spend it somewhere else, that it could have more profit and economical impact than we shouldn't. Because OT is the heart of the organization. Spending, it should be part of your priority. I know that today with this low price environment, a lot of people are looking into cost optimization and try to prioritize their capital spending and where should they invest their money. I think this is a real threat for us and we need to spend and we are as a management, we should be committed to that. So we shouldn't try to take this some amount of money from here to give it to some area else that maybe it could have a lower impact if we think this is a serious threat for us and it has a huge impact on the organization in the future.
Bughazi, if you're given the choice between security and mobilities, where do you go?
Actually, this is a great question. I'll go for balancing between the two each other. Mobility is something we have to move on. You know that a lot of offices outside the refinery now is handling a lot of calculation, planning. So we have to balance. Security will take priority, but we have to balance, move forward for more mobility, same time putting more protection, more secure system in order not to intrude into the OT. But this should not prevent us from moving forward into technology mobility because, you know, there is a risk. The risk is always there. We had to handle the risk. We have to put a plan to mitigate it, a lot of protection. And as mentioned by Ziad, if it's required to maintain a separate server, We don't mind. We can continue the same this, but definitely giving access to the OT is becoming a must these days because you know you have to move on with technology.
Let me move on, and the MC is very keen that we finish on time, and she has the time kept exactly the way it should be, so we'll be very clear about that one. One thing which is, I think, both Mr. Nizar and yourself mentioned it, is the information. And sharing the information, and disseminating the knowledge which is we have, and trying to really have all these experts and our specialists aware of what's happening. Do you think we are doing enough? And what do you think is we are lacking? And what we need to do to really raise this bar a bit higher in the future? Boaz, let me start with you.
Well, I'll be frank with you. Really, we are not doing enough. The knowledge and best practice sharing, we are not doing enough. I don't want to say we are disappointed that, you know, KEOX, the last conference was 2 years ago. So this is... we lost an opportunity to share information. I think among Kuwait, we need to do more to share information, to share knowledge, to share best practice. Then moving forward to GCC, we have to share like the attack happened to KMBC to summer 2015. I'm sure our IT, they a lot of lesson learned. They have a case study. If this is shared between JCC companies and the downstream, and or even down upstreams, this will be very helpful. So we are not doing enough. I think this forum is a good base to start. And I was very happy that when I heard about the CITRA is in Kuwait.
Can you tell us about CITRA for people understand what we talk about CITRA?
I don't know, stand for the Hayal Amma Al-Tisalat.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So they are building NCC, which is National Security Center. They just started.
Good.
I'm sure there is a speaker from CITRA also today in the conference. Which
I hope
is,
they are here.
So this is a good start. They have the center. We had cross-functional teams. I think we have to do more in the K companies first, moving to Kuwait, then GCC to share the knowledge. So we have our people here, most of our IT manager and team is here. We will support establishing a network between Kuwait and JCC to share information and lessons.
I mean, the push is to push it to the OT guys also. The OT guys need to also to be involved in that one. I think that's what you are saying. Not just the IT, the OT guys need to be moving this way.
When I talk both IT and OT, knowledge sharing in the organization and outside the organization.
Wafa, I'm a bit running out of time, so...
I agree with Boghazi. We are not doing enough. We just started. The first starting point that we started by admitting that this is a real threat for us. And having this conference is another evidence, the third year that we are doing it. So this is one as a starting point. We are as a KPC, as an organization, now cybersecurity is one of our top risk in our risk register. On our agenda, we have a risk operating committee.
Part of the ARM.
Part of the ARM. Uh-huh. We have a risk operating committee headed by leaders from the whole K companies. We keep monitoring this type of risk. What is the mitigation that the companies are doing to mitigate this type of risk? This is one. In addition to that, we have formed steering committee for cybersecurity across the KPC organization. And it is headed by Mr. Basim Isa. This is one also forum that it's a good opportunity for sharing the practices, lesson learned across the organization about cybersecurity. Boghazi mentioned that at a government level, we have this committee, which is headed by CITRA. And this is an opportunity also to set the systems, the policies for cybersecurity. We need more. I think one of the things that maybe we need to expand it further across the GCC, across oil and gas companies. We need to be, as an oil, gas, and companies, you see there is a lot of incidents in